Well, I mean, it sounds like it's going to be a really nice website. I mean, I think we're all excited about the ease and efficiency that we're going to be able to enjoy in you know, finding who the commissioner is I need to talk to, or right. or getting my hunting license, or applying to be or filling the proper requirements for to become a cosmetologist, or whatever that might be. So let's take a look and see some of the additions that are that we're going to see here.
Well, what you'll be looking at here, in essence, is the culmination of really lots and lots of hours to get to this point, with participation with a number of state agencies, leadership within various departments and offices and so forth, Office of Technology, and really looked at, you know, what's the most, you know, what are some of those things, those sites that are out there that we really like? What are some of those things, which states are doing well? A lot of research went into creating this website. And really what we've done is we've taken the concept of a tourism website, a government website, and a business website, and we've rolled them into one design that really reflects what we think is the natural wonder and beauty that West Virginia provides to the citizens. So when you come to the website, it won't be this terrible, very difficult interface to use. You'll actually have something that is pleasing to look at, that you know, is inviting and is very friendly. That was one of the big things, was the user-friendly component to this, so that when you come to the website, it's not going to be this learning process where you have to figure out where things are at. We have a live help service that's available in the upper right-hand corner. If you notice, it's up here. We refer to this as page-level assistance. So if you want to chat with somebody to help answer your question, all you have to do, every website that's on the new portal, you come up to live help Monday through Friday, 8 to 5. We can chat with you and help direct you and guide you with what you're looking for. If the font, if the actual text on the page is not large enough, you can simply, with a quick click of a button, you'll be able to change that font size, and it'll now be available for you to view in a larger. So there were a lot of thought, a lot of really research went into this, and now what we've done is we've gone out to every agency website, and we've looked to see from the Secretary of State's office, how do I access UCC filing information? If I want to register a business, what services are available? From tourism and from the commerce, you know, workforce development, all these agencies, we've researched all their websites and we've pulled out what we think are the most important resources that folks would be looking for all these agencies. Well, we've taken all that information and we've now made it accessible through the state portal. So if you're looking for a birth certificate or a death certificate, things of that sort, all those services will be readily available. And let me just give you a quick view of what I'm kind of talking about here. When you think about services, we thought that, you know, the primarily folks coming to the website, they're either a business or they're a citizen, and in some cases, in many cases, it's also a government employee. But in terms of a public representation of government, we think that businesses and citizens are really coming to this site to find out how to file a tax or how to register that business. And so we've organized those business, those services here into two categories, business services and citizen services, so that you can kind of highlight those areas that you may be directly interested in. So as a citizen, if you're interested in getting a copy of your birth certificate, that's maybe a featured service at this time. If you're a business and it's time for Secretary of State filing, you can come out here and learn how to file your annual report online. Likewise, if it's hunting and fishing season and you're getting ready to get out, you know, it's the hunting trips this weekend, but you don't have your license, you can come right out here to the state portal and have quick access to where you would actually buy that online. And these will all change out depending on what is going on in government right now. So if it's tax season, we're going to have tax services that are available. If it's time for voting, we're going to have information on how to access those voting resources. So all that information, this is very interactive and fluid depending on what's occurring in state government. Oftentimes, citizens and businesses, they have a question when they come to visit the state website. It's things that we've already talked about. How do I register my business? How do I get a copy of my birth certificate? Well, those questions are also going to be predominant here. So we're going to have a list of predefined questions, again, that are representative of what's occurring right now. A lot of these will be based on trends that we see throughout the mm-hmm. website and things of that sort. But if you're trying to register your vehicle, you know, how do you do that? So if you click this link, it's going to take you out to the DMV, and it'll take you to the resource and that information where it's going to talk about how to register your vehicle mm-hmm. and things of that sort. If you're interested in a popular form, maybe it's voting, it's time for voting and you want to fill out your voter registration card and get that in the mail, you'll be able to go out here and actually write in here, mail-in voter registration application. It's very relevant to what's going on right now. Get that processed, and it's easily accessible from the state homepage. If for some reason you don't find the service that you're looking for, you can easily engage other areas of the site to get more services. So if you clicked See More Online Services, you would be taken out to a page that has an index of all those services and systems that you can conduct online. It's similarly to the questions. Maybe your question isn't answered here, but you could quickly go out to look at all the questions and find what you were looking for, similar to the forms. The other main component on the site here is the state news. From a communication standpoint, that's one of the, if you look about a democracy, is, you know, communication to folks on what agencies are doing. So we've developed this news center that will basically culminate all of agencies' press releases into this unified system. So if you've heard recently about a tax cut, or you've heard recently about a new initiative that's affecting your local municipality, all those agencies can now publish those news releases through the centralized resource. So you know that anytime a state news is released, you can go to this resource to access that information directly. This is also syndicated for those of you that are familiar with RSS feeds right. and things of that sort. You'll be able to pull those into your distribution media to look at those as well. You don't necessarily have to come to the state portal to look at that.
I've already talked to our website person. We're going to add that so that you can add yours.
Perfect.
Well.
Mm-hmm.
And when you look at the site, you'll see that there's nothing that's agency or departmental specific. It is mm-hmm. really, if I want to know about education, that's what I click on. Employment, government, health. Mm-hmm. Those are the primary categories that we're looking at that hopefully will be able to help that person drive down through and find the information that they want.
Hopefully, as well as what you can also see with this design is that it was really important that it be representative of the state. And so as you load different pages or you go into different sections of the site, for example, business, if I was going into this area to learn more about how to conduct business in the state of West Virginia, we're going to have imagery that's representative of the business climate mm-hmm. here. So, for example, here we have a steel worker mm-hmm. who's working on some machinery. And those pictures change. So if you're in the tourism section of the website, all these images change out so that it's more reflective of that particular area of the site that you're visiting. And now that we're here on the secondary page of the website, we're in the business section. This is really the home page for the high-level business resources that you may be interested in. So if you're trying to find out about how to register to get a sales tax license with the Department of Revenue, well, you could come out here and find out where to access that information. If you are looking to register your business, you might find out that, well, there's an online system in West Virginia. You may not have known that. You can actually register your business with many state agencies online through Business for West Virginia, and that will be made available. It's actually, we reference it over here. It's the business registration system as a featured online service. We also have a lot of the agencies that you're interested in visiting, for example, the tax department. Right here from the business portal, you'll be able to have direct access to the tax department to conduct or ask questions directly with them if you need to go talk to them after you've researched more information through the state portal.